In the late 80s, Honda set out to make a motorcycle that the people needed, but that is not what they wanted. With the steep price tag just under $4,000 and its strange looks, the production of the Hawk GT only lasted for 4 years, 1988 through 91. For only $400 more, the people were more interested in the new fully fared CBR 600, or otherwise known as the Hurricane. The Hawk was the first naked sport bike, and its style gave birth to many modern-day motorcycles, such as the Ducati Monster, the Supermotards, and the SV650s. The Hawk GT was the first motorcycle in America and second in the world to come with the single-sided swing arm and sporting the aluminum perimeter frame. Honda borrowed the engine from their XRV650 Africa Twin dual sport that was developed by the Honda Racing Corporation. This V-twin features single overhead cams, 3 valves per cylinder, liquid cooling, and a 5-speed transmission. It has a 53-inch wheelbase, a 30-inch seat height, and a dry weight just under 400 pounds. The Hawk has a low center of gravity, and with a rake of 27 degrees and a trail of 4.4 inches, this is one flickable machine. The riding experience is more supermoto than sport bike. In the late 80s, early 90s, a racer named Craig Erion wasn't happy with his Ducati's performance, so he bought a Hawk GT to race. His brother Kevin went on to win 2 national championships on his Hawk GT, and so was born Two Brothers Racing. Two Brothers Racing made a full system exhaust for the Hawk. They called it their legacy model for the company because the Hawk GT is what put them on the map. Honda's North American Director of Research and Development admitted to personally owning 2 Hawks and said they were her inspiration for the new line of 500s, the CB500F, X, and the CBR500R. The Hawk GT is the textbook definition of a cult bike, and its following is legendary. The Hawk's longevity and continued popularity and handling capabilities compared to modern bikes almost 30 years later is proof enough that Honda made a great motorcycle just a few years too soon.
So I know a lot of you ADV riders say that you don't have any desire to ride street, but if you lived 3 to 4 hours away from some of the best motorcycle roads in the country, the question is, why wouldn't you ride street? Now I really wish I could show you what this bike could do, but I'm just your average rider. A good day for me is stay smooth, have fun, and don't die. So we've got an 80s bike, an 80s chick. I say we need a song from the 80s to make this ride complete. Aerosmith, Skid Row, Bon Jovi. There we go. How about a little Poison? All right.